Shorts creators can now join and earn money from the YouTube Partner Program. Let's walk through how Shorts creators can join YPP, how Shorts ad revenue sharing works, and how you can view your Shorts earnings and performance. First, how can Shorts creators join the YouTube Partner Program? Shorts creators can apply to the program with 1,000 subscribers and 10 million eligible public Shorts views in the last 90 days. Or, creators can also qualify with 1,000 subscribers and 4,000 valid public watch hours on long-form videos. Your content also must follow YouTube's originality policy, which means the content you upload must be your original content and not someone else's. YouTube looks to reward original and authentic content that adds value to viewers. If you put a funny or thoughtful spin on content you didn't originally create, say for example by using our remix tools, you've transformed the content in some way. In other words, we allow reused content if viewers can tell that there's a meaningful difference between the original video and your video. Next, let's walk through how Shorts ad revenue sharing will work. Shorts have a unique ad revenue sharing model. Here are the four steps to how it works. First, Shorts feed ad revenue is pooled. Each month, revenue from the ads appearing between Shorts in the Shorts feed will be added together and used to reward monetizing Shorts creators and cover the costs of music licensing. Next, the creator pool is calculated. A portion of the total Shorts feed ad revenue will be allocated to the creator pool based on views and music usage across all watch Shorts. If a creator uploads a short without music, all of the revenue associated with its views goes towards the creator pool. If a creator uploads a short with music, the revenue associated with its views will be split among the creator pool and music partners based on the number of tracks used. For example, a short featuring one music track would have half of its revenue go towards the creator pool and half set aside for music licensing. A short with two music tracks would have a third of its revenue go towards the creator pool and two-thirds go towards music licensing. Then, the creator pool is allocated to creators. From the creator pool in each country, we'll allocate revenue to monetizing Shorts creators based on their share of total Shorts views in the creator pool. For example, let's say out of all the Shorts uploaded by monetizing creators, you got 5% of eligible views. You would then be allocated 5% of the revenue in the creator pool, regardless of if you used music or not. Finally, the Shorts revenue share is applied. Monetizing creators will keep 45% of their allocated Shorts revenue. So for example, if you're allocated $1,000 from the creator pool, you'll be paid $450. To recap, the four steps of Shorts ad revenue sharing are: 1. Shorts feed ad revenue is pooled. 2. The creator pool is calculated. 3. The creator pool is then allocated to creators. 4. The Shorts revenue share is applied for each creator. Because Shorts don't have traditional watch pages like long-form videos, this approach will help us reward all monetizing creators who make up the Shorts experience, not just those who have an ad next to their video. And as an added benefit, this model lets creators achieve their creative vision without worrying about copyright or earning less due to using music. We can't wait to see what Shorts creators do with this new source of revenue. Finally, let's walk through how you can view your Shorts earnings and performance. In YouTube Studio Analytics, the Revenue tab will show your daily estimated revenue and views by content type. And the How You Make Money card will show you a more detailed view of how you're earning across Shorts, video, and live content. For more information on Shorts and the YouTube Partner Program, check out the links in the description. Thanks for watching.